Good afternoon. Thanks for joining in this session. First of all, I hope everybody is fine, and I hope everybody is working from home, right? So in this pandemic situations, and everybody's family is well in this situation. So thanks for joining in. Thanks for giving your time. So I will go through, along with me from NTT, Devashish is also there. He is the partner manager. So Devashish, are you there?
Yeah, Koushik.
Yeah, okay. So so I am the regional solutions architect of NTT based in Kolkata. My office is in Webel sector 5. So if you want to touch base, you can touch base with me while in Kolkata. Let me go through this journey of 1 and 1.5 hour of this session so that I can give you some of the input about the challenges that we are facing and how we can overcome that. And definitely I will go through our product portfolio and our services offering to the market. So, we are NTT is quite a Fortune 500 company. So our total revenue is around 120 billion. We are having presence in more than 196 countries all over the world. And in India, we are working, NTT and NTT Netmagic is working as an SBU of NTT's data center business. Our main office is in Mumbai. And we are based out of in every region in India. I am handling the solutions architect and the presales part, along with the salesperson is also there. His name is Dronacharya. So we both are handling East as a region. And I hope those who are not aware about the NTT. So NTT Netmagic is one of the multi-cloud service provider in this particular domain. And we are a pure ICT-based company which offers end-to-end solutions regarding any ICT solutions. Okay, so as I have discussed, right now we are one of the best data center companies in Asian market. We also awarded as a Gartner leader coordinate in managed hybrid data center kind of offerings. And we are in Fortune 500 companies. We hold the 15th rank in the global. So I will not go through about, I will skip this particular slide, because this is all about our how NTT is working. So this is NTT India. So we have an office on 11. We having a data center around 13 data center all across. So it's a little bit old slide. We having a 13 data center across all over India. So in Mumbai we have around 7 data centers. In Bangalore we have 3 data centers. Apart from that, we have a data center in Chennai as well as in Noida. And we have an office in 4 regions in India, and we have an R&D center in Pune as well as in Bangalore. So these are the few certificates which we have. One of them is the PCI DSS certificate. Another one is the CERTIN certificate. PCI DSS certificate is one of the mandatory certificate to host kind of an PTM or kind of an platform where you need a transactions kind of a model. So these are the one of the certificates which we have. We are SAP certified. We have our SAP certified grid also. We are HANA certified provider, which we are giving the services from our own data centers. So and rest of the other services, other certificates which we have in our feather. Okay. So these are the few OEMs and partners which we work along with. You, I want to name it. One is the VMware. VMware is the one of the key OEM which is working tightly with us, and we are providing in the services to the end customer along with them, along to the end customers. Another service provider is we closely work with Cisco, we closely work with Dell, EMC, you name any OEM, we work with them very closely. Apart from that, NTT is definitely we are one of the sister companies of the NTT. So NTT Communications, NTT Data, these are the dimension data. These are the one of the sister companies of under the NTT group companies. So now I just want to highlight about what are the service portfolio we cover. So as I have told you, we are a pure ICT-based company. That means we provide the data center services. Not only that, we provide the network services as well as the security, managed security services, as cloud services, hosting services, co-location services, etc. So our services is broadly categorized in these five domains. One is the data center services, which mainly includes the co-location services, the bandwidth services, as to connect any data center you need the bandwidth. So we have the licensing from NTT. We will work jointly with NTT Communications to provide that. Any kind of an ILL, we can work along with you and along with NTT Communications to offer you the ILL services to the end customer. Apart from that, we provide the remote hand support and all the other services also. In the domain of hosted IT services, as you are, I hope everybody is aware about the cloud and hosting services. So in kind of an hosting services, we provide the dedicated hostings, pre-provisioned server, managed firewall, load balancer, backup and storage, disaster recovery, data center migration solutions, and system integration solutions, these kind of services. So, last but not the least, we have the we are one of the multi-cloud service provider in India. So one of our main IP is the managed security portal. That particular portal gives you the visibility and the control all across the data center or all across the cloud service provider. So we have our own cloud as well as we work jointly with Google, Azure, or Amazon, and these public cloud service provider also. So in our own cloud services, we provide basically the infrastructure as a service. Yeah, is there any question?
Nothing. So I'll monitor the questions. So maybe once you complete the presentation, we can have a moderation and Q&A session.
Okay, great. I think someone is raising his hand or something. So that's why I stopped.
No, that's for everyone. So if you have any specific queries during the session, you can use the chat box. As a moderator, I'll translate the question to Koushik so that it goes seamless. Thank you.
Okay, great. Thank you. Thanks, Shubham.
Yeah.
So in cloud service, I just want to give you a little bit brief about what Netmagic thinks or what NTT Netmagic thinks jointly in kind of a cloud services portfolio. So we believe in a hybrid cloud kind of business propositions. And so we provide any kind of a cloud, be it a private cloud, be it be it a public cloud or be it a hybrid cloud. But NTT believes in a hybrid cloud scenario where NTT believes that every workload cannot be suited in a public cloud model, or private cloud is very costly or not that much efficient where every services can go like the public cloud. So NTT believes in a hybrid cloud scenario, and NTT have their own IP. So that's one of the major value propositions which NTT brings in. NTT have a portal from where you can manage or monitor any cloud services, not only the NTT NetMagic's own cloud, but also the cloud service which is in the market, or the public cloud service provider, that is AWS, Azure, Google, or any cloud service provider. Okay, so that's one of the key value propositions which NTT gives you. Apart from that, NTT NetMagic have an offerings of the simply VPC, DR on cloud, storage as a service, and database as a service. In terms of the managed services, so I will all of the services I will go into deep dive, and I will discuss what are those services and how we can update that. In terms of the managed services, managed security services, we have our own SOC from our data center, so we provide a managed security services, which definitely gives you the remote SOC kind of a model, which you provide as a service. So where every security services is there. Apart from that, we provide a few infrastructure applications as a service, like the Exchange, Linux Mail, SAP Basis, middleware support. Oh, these are the services which we provide. Okay, and from the network services, we provide the IPVPN, we provide the internet, that is the bandwidth, as well as we provide the ILL kind of services to the end customer. Apart from that, we provide the SD-WAN services, which is the new norms in any enterprise organizations. They are opting SD-WAN in a full manner, right? So because SD-WAN is one of the crucial services which will give you that flexibility in this kind of a pandemic model. So now I just want to brief about what are our public cloud. So these are so we name our public cloud so as a simply cloud. So we have 5 availability zone. We provide infrastructure service as well as platform as a service. We can provide you to maximum 99.99% SLA, which is on-demand scalable. Apart from that, we provide the DB as a services, as well as backup as a service, and the whole grid is PCI DSS certificate, as well as ISO 27001 and ISO 9001 certified also. Okay, so and almost more than 2000 plus VM. This is a old slides. So I just want to give you almost 2000 plus VM is spinning from our own simply cloud services. So if you have any questions, you can type in on the chat box. We can give you all those answers in while we go into the question answer sessions. So now how you can use these services. These are so simply cloud few are the services which simply cloud gives the scaling is horizontal or the vertical, both are possible. You can schedule to run your VM or to run your network to run spin up your VM at any point of time. It's there are any kind of a billing model like any public cloud provider have, that is the pay-per-use model, which having the monthly billing model, hourly billing model, as well as you can opt for kind of a 3 months advance or that kind of a billing model also, which is the PO based model. So apart from that, these all are the template based services. You can integrate with your APIs also from your on premise. And REST API is there, so all are built up with the REST API. You can integrate easily with our Simply Cloud provisioning group. These are the few services on the Simply Cloud. So you can apart from that, as NTT believes in a hybrid cloud kind of a scenario, so NTT and security is one of the main concern in a hybrid cloud scenario. So from NTT you can opt in a public cloud scenario, you can opt dedicated firewall also, in which can be integrated with your public cloud. So apart from that, any load balancer, a virtual load balancer, any firewall, any virtual firewall, there are a lot of firewalls as a service is there. One is the VM based firewall, another one is the LDAM based firewall, which is virtual in nature. Apart from that, we have a dedicated firewall also, which can be integrated in our Simply Cloud. Now, as I have told you, NTT believes in a kind of a hybrid cloud model. So NTT believes that every workload cannot be suitable for public cloud scenario, right? So what is the solutions for that? So NTT have came up with another solutions which we name as a Simply VPC kind of a model. Simply VPC is a virtual private cloud service provider, which you can think of that you are building your own cloud from the resources which is dedicated to you. So NTT has an offerings and which is basically in a cloud aligned model, where NTT gives you dedicated compute kind of a model. So you can opt for dedicated compute. From that, you can provision your own VM from that dedicated compute, and you can create your own cloud or onto a cloud from our cloud. Okay, so that's on demand virtual private cloud. It's a dedicated computer resource pool. You can create your own network, own private cloud instantly. You have your self-service portal, and it's all our software defined in nature. So, and apart from that, every network is under the software defined network on that particular dedicated a cloud service which you are creating from a resource pool of the whole cloud grid of the Netmagic. So these are the few key features of our Simply VPC. It's on demand private cloud. Okay, so it's configurable within a minute. It can run any mission critical infrastructure, right? If someone wants to host their own ERP onto our cloud, this is one of the best suitable cloud in the industry. So we have a lot of customers in East. They are running HANA from our these services. So we can name it. One of the name is the Builder Sugar. Another is the CMRI. Another is the Century Ply. These are few names which I want to highlight. There are lot of other customers also. But right now, I just want to highlight these three. Apart from MAP, we have around more than 30 plus customers in SAP HANA from the East. So these are the few models which we Simply VPC provide. So So our base model name as an VPC launcher, then comes the VPC cruiser, then comes the VPC supersonic model. So it starts from 2 into 10 core kind of an scenario. Then it increase up to 2 into 24 kind of an socket based its model, right? So and you can opt these services, these particular dedicated compute, or with the full flexibility of the cloud and paper are used kind of a model which your public cloud also give you, but it's a dedicated for you. So it has the more stringent performance, as well as from the security reason also, you are not sharing your backplane with any other customers. So it's more secure in nature, more tightly coupled, held you have your own infrastructure to run with. So these are the few Netmagic in terms of the cloud service portfolio. These are the few key benefits which I just want to highlight. So we have the three kinds of a model in cloud. One is the Simply Cloud, which is basically the public cloud. Another one is the Simply VPC, which is basically the virtual private cloud, so that every resources is not as private as pure play private cloud offer, but the main component, like the security component, the as well as the compute component, is dedicated to you, so that you can have the best resources or the best performance, as well as the security tightly coupled to offer to the end customers. And in terms of the private cloud, we just want to highlight, we provide the private cloud also, but it case to case basis. And as well as if customers wants to build their own private cloud into our data center, from our data center, we help the customers also to build their private cloud with helping the all features which we provide from our Simply Cloud as well as the Simply VPC. So apart from that, in terms of the Simply Cloud offerings, things which we just want to highlight, our Simply Cloud offerings is an enterprise-grade public cloud, which is based on a VMware kind of a hypervisor kind of a model. So it's basically enterprise and grid. We have 5 availability zone in India, as well as our Simply Cloud gives you the compute or fully our compute grid is fully managed and provisions automatically, as well as we have our SD-WAN kind of features and the SDN kind of features from our private cloud or the public cloud, or as well as we have the provide or DR as a service from that particular cloud also. In terms of the Simply VPC, we provide 2 kinds of a Simply VPC model, which is basically the virtual private cloud. So we provide 2 kind of a model. One is underneath the hypervisor is VMware, another one is the Hyper-V. So we provide these 2 flavors in terms of the Simply VPC, as well as there are many offerings as there in terms of the sizing of that Simply VPC model. So we have 3 kinds of a model. One is the base model, which starts with 2 into 10 sockets kind of a model, then it gradually grows up to 2 into 24 base socket model also. So is there any question still now, Shushobhan? If you can highlight, it will be good, because it will
there are some questions like there are software designing services, a lot of things are coming up, so how those kind of services will be beneficial in adoption of Netmagic Cloud? And also the question like what are the benefits of Netmagic compared to the public cloud? These are the 2 questions.
So to give you the answer in the second questions, I will come on the first question later. So first of all, to give you the second question answer, is first thing is we provide the public cloud also from our grid, as well as we work with AWS, Azure, Google, all the providers in terms of the public cloud kind of a model. So I'm not getting to whom you are comparing. Then I can give you the one-to-one battle card why Netmagic Cloud is better, or why should people go ahead with the Netmagic.
No, so he has not specified any specific provider, because now also one more question came out, like how Netmagic works out a better solution than customer's own data center. This is a traditional question, like own data center, why someone will move to a cloud provider.
Cloud. Okay. So this I think this question is answered by every cloud service provider, right? So I am once again iterating the same thing. So if it is a own data center, you have to build your all the services, which includes the huge number of capex, as well as the flexibility and agility is not there in terms of their own data center. If you want to build their own data center, while if you offer your services from Netmagic Cloud or the entity's whole portfolio of the services, yes, it will be pay-per-use kind of a model. Not only that, you can run few workload from AWS, few workload from the Netmagic Cloud, few workload from the Google Cloud, and you can have a single dashboard which you can manage and monitor through our own IP, which is built by NTT. Okay, so suppose I just want to give you one example. Suppose we have not built the huge services in terms of the analytics as a service.
So we
offer analytics kind of a service, or the big data kind of a service is working with AWS or working with Google. Also, so if some customer have that analytics kind of an workload, they can opt that services from AWS and Azure, while those workloads, which is very predictive in nature, right? So suppose they want to host their HANA, right? So now they want to host their HANA infrastructure 24/7, 365 kind of a model. So that kind of a predictive workload, they can easily go ahead with the Netmagic, which can gives you the total ROI very much lesser. And all these services they can opt from a single dashboard, single monitoring, and both these services can be managed and monitored, wholly managed by Netmagic.
So there is my answer. One more specific question, like someone specified the top three public clouds are AWS, Azure, and GCP. So instead of that, why suddenly someone will go to Netmagic? Though I think you have already discussed that, but still someone still has come out, so you can repeat the statement once again.
So as I have told you, we are not competing with anyone, AWS, Azure, or Google. We are a multi-cloud service provider. So we are the partner of these three, and we are the global, one of the best partner in market in India. So as we work globally along with these three providers, so Netmagic believes in a hybrid cloud scenario. They don't believe in a pure public cloud scenario. So Netmagic have their own public cloud, as well as Netmagic you can opt any cloud, like the AWS, Azure, and Google, right? So but it depends on very specific to specific case studies kind of an environment, right? So it depends on the ROI, it depends on the TCO. So it will be very vague if I can tell you that these so every possible scenario is suitable for only NTT Netmagic, and no other cloud services can give you the better solutions like us. So if you can give me any specific case studies, then I can give you a consultative approach, or NTT Netmagic can give you a consultative approach. So you should go for AWS, you should go for GCP, or you should go for entity's Netmagic's own simply cloud or simply VPC kind of a model. So it's basically case-to-case basis rather than I can blindly say is that we are best in the market or we are worst in the market kind of a scenario.
Sure, you can proceed with the presentation. So we can take the questions, other questions later.
So, Sushobhan, what was the first question?
First question was in the remote working kind of environment, a lot of new softwares are being built. So there are urgencies in software built up and production. So those kind of environment, maybe for software companies, how what is the kind of agility or kind of environment Netmagic can provide for those customers and even the providers? So faster deployment,
okay,
of new softwares.
Okay, so as we have already discussed, so in this kind of a scenario, Netmagic can definitely work with the customers with Netmagic's offering Simply Cloud, as well as because as this is it is a pure public cloud, it can spin up within 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, and after provisioning that particular resources, yes, the software vendors or those people who are coming up with the new softwares, they can build their software, they can test their software from our infrastructure as a service. On top of that, our infrastructure as a service is not only that, we have the 5 availability zone in India. So as we have the more number of zones in India, we can give you a very much good throughput while accessing from your own data centers or accessing from your own offices. So for Netmagic Simply Cloud offerings. So is my answer is clear or they want something else?
Yeah, sure. Nothing else so far. So maybe you can pass it
forward. Okay. So these are the cloud portfolio which Netmagic provides. So so what I am again and again emphasizing, this is I just want to give you this IP or the intelligent property which Netmagic have, that is the Netmagic multi-cloud based single dashboard kind of an MNP portal, Netmagic multi-cloud hybrid portal. Also, so we have built our own portal which can give you the all kind of an environment on a single dashboard, and from that particular dashboard you can manage and monitor your infrastructure as be your or your services are in kind of an co-locations model or in a Netmagic cloud or in a Azure cloud or in a Amazon cloud or you have your own cloud. So we can work along with you and we can give you the single dashboard from where you can manage and monitor every locations with a single dashboard. Okay, because as cloud is coming right now into the market and everybody is talking about the cloud, everybody have of their own portal. So it's very difficult for the end customers to go and provisions with the own cloud portal of like AWS or Azure or Netmagic. So it will give you end customer life very simple if they can manage with a cloud management portal. So Netmagic gives a CMP portal which cut across any offerings. So now I just want to give you the approach of the Netmagic security as a service or SOC services. So in terms of the SOC security services, we have the whole SOC portfolio or we give the whole SOC services from our data center, which is in Mumbai as well as Chennai and Bangalore. So we provide the volumetric mitigation services, DDoS services. We provide the next generation IPS and IDS services. We provide the DDoS services. We provide the VAPT kind of services. We provide the SIEM services. We provide the next generation firewall as a service, as well as the mitigations of that particular service. So these are the threat management kind of a service. So as you can see from the slides, we provide the DDoS service, we provide the WAP services of the cloud, we provide the web control, we provide the shadow map, we provide meter DDoS, managed firewall, managed IPS, as well as the any host-based protection service like HIPS, antivirus, anti-malware, or CNAM services, VAPT firewall audit analysis services. So these are the few activities, SOC activities. So what we give, we provide the security workshops and the security designs and security implementations. Then the operations teams come into the picture. We give you the 24/7 response kind of time, and they gives you to the end customer their dashboard also, which is happening from our shop. Okay, so they give you the full visibility. Apart from that, they provide the visibility of the reports, the audit reports of the vulnerability assessment, penetration testing, any reports. And on top of that, from additionals of the consultative services, as Netmagic also give if the advisory reports which you need to implement, which are the bugs is there in terms of the security services. So these are the few services and vis-a-vis to the OEM. So in terms of the firewall, DAM, ETDR, host IPS, SIPM, WAF, these are the few OEMs which we want to highlight in terms of the security services.
যেমন আমি নিচে একটা দেখেছি তোমাকে স্যাম্পল দিয়েছি আমরা আগে একবার ফোন করেছিলাম ইচিতে
নাও আই জাস্ট ওয়ান্ট টু গো অ্যাহেড উইথ দি নেটম্যাজিক ম্যানেজ এই আইটেম গুলো দেখান অ্যাকচুয়ালি নেটম্যাজিক ম্যানেজ সার্ভিসেস নেটম্যাজিক গুগল ফর সাম ম্যানেজড ক্লাউড ওই গুগল অর দা কোলোকেশন এন্ড সার্ভিস সিকিউরিটি ম্যানেজ বেসিক্যালি মাইক্রোসফট এসেনশিয়াল এর নেটম্যাজিক গিভস ইউ এই পাঁচটা আইটেম আমি সাকসেস প্লেথোরা লাইক দি ক্লাউড ম্যানেজ সার্ভিসেস ভার্চুয়াল ফাইলস ম্যানেজ সার্ভিসেস ভার্চুয়ালাইজেশন ম্যানেজ সার্ভিসেস স্টোরেজ ম্যানেজ সার্ভিসেস ব্যাকআপ অ্যাজ এ সার্ভিস
তাহলে পাশে ডেসক্রিপশন বলে একটা কলামে এগুলো লিখে দাও ভাই আছে অনেক কোন বোঝালাম আমি আর পার্থ মিলে
Not only that, Netmagic can work along with you and work along with you and provide the remote infrastructure management as a service to your data center. So in East, we are working similar kind of a model with CMRI. We are providing the whole services of the remote infrastructure management and monitoring services of the CMRI. So these are the few technologies which we have highlighted in our presentations. There are plethora of services which we support and which our team support. So these all are not mentioned over here, but we just want to highlight few over here. From the hardware point of view, we support HP, Dell, IBM, any hardware need for load balancer, storage, any kind of storage and NAS dash. These are the technologies, supported technologies I'm talking about from the managed services point of view. I'm emphasizing these because few customers want to co-locate their own infrastructure and want to opt the managed services from us, right? So that kind of an, if somebody wants a that kind of an cloud kind of a model. That is why we are emphasizing that
Windows,
we support all these,
10 upgrade,
these technologies.
10 enterprise upgrade. Windows 10.
So these are the few services from the Netmagic.
Windows enterprise
service. So these are the few differentiator. So we focus on the data center infrastructure. We are basically the data center infrastructure provide service providers.
So
we have our own data center which are managing 24/7/365, as well as we have our own cloud. As not only that, we are managing other public clouds also from our own data centers. So in terms of the data center services kind of a model, we are one of the best in India, and we are providing that services more than 20 to 25 years in India. And NTT Netmagic is a big company. We still believe that in kind of a startup kind of a model. So every hour higher management is very much available through phone or calls, and they are very customer centric in terms of the providing the services to the customers. These are one of the key criteria why Netmagic is different from the other service provider.
Free office access.
Now, in this scenario, as we all aware that what kind of an situations we are going on, we just want to highlight one more services, which is the SD-WAN kind of services. I hope everybody heard about the SD-WAN kind of model or the service or the term. Is there anyone who have not heard this particular term, SD-WAN? Okay, there is one person has asked, how does Netmagic compete with controlless and Reliance Cloud Holo DC? Okay. So everybody, so you are also so controlless and Reliance is one of our
online
competitor in the market. So Netmagic is a company which purely
all features
believes in a transparency kind of a model, and purely in a ethical kind of a model.
Exchange online.
There are a lot of incidents in terms of the controllers. I don't want to highlight Reliance, but in terms of the controllers, there are a lot of services which they offers, but in the back end they don't report to the particular OEM. Okay, so maybe
teams.
We day in and day out we fight with controllers as well as the Reliance, but in terms of our global footprint and our services footprint point of view, Netmagic is very much enriched rather than controllers as well as the Reliance. Okay, so let me go into the SD-WAN kind of a model. Yeah, anybody have any questions?
Yeah, somebody asked about SD-WAN. Karun, what is he saying? Fair enough. You are on the SD-WAN only, so someone was asking for SD-WAN. So you continue.
Okay. So SD-WAN is a kind of a service which NTT Netmagic and NTT Communications jointly worked and came up with this particular services, which is software defined WAN. Right now In this kind of a scenario, internet is the main backbone for internet is the main backbone for any service, right? So and day in and day out, while coming the broadband as well as the ILL services is more stable rather than and 20 or 10 years back or the 5 years back. So SD-WAN is a kind of a service is where we are providing the control plane in the cloud. So all the decisions from the network topologies are network routing, the base per surface part and scenarios all are being managed into a control center which is in the cloud. Then the network panel is shifting onto a particular box which is called as a CPE box, which is the customer premises equipment box. So this kind of an and this kind of a model SD-WAN doesn't rely on any transport layer. It is a very transport independent kind of a system.
Manual control.
1 minute.
Correct.
So, and as well as give you the flexibility to work with any provider. Okay, so suppose you have your MPLS connections, you have your broadband connections, you have your only the dongle connections, but you want to have a secure 256 bit secure connections all together. SD-WAN is a that kind of an that kind of model which gives you greater flexibility, greater control with a lower cost. Because right now the transport layer that is the ILL or the bandwidth, broadband bandwidth is very cheaper in nature rather than the MPLS. So these are the few enablement which is the features of the SD-WAN. I just want to highlight one of the case studies. So suppose the customer have one site. Customer have two sites. Okay. Now they want another sites is in HP or the DC. So they have all total they have three sites. Now, from a central policy point of view, they want to deploy a central policies. So previously what we used to do, so they cannot deploy or they cannot manage from a central location. So if you have to manage, you have to go to the firewall, you have to go to the switches, you have to go to the each locations and L3 devices, L2 devices, then you can enable all these policies. But as MPLS as SD-WAN give you a better flexibility and better operability and the control. Well, from anywhere you can log onto your particular locations and you can design your whole network with a single few click. Suppose not only that, SD-WAN give you the applications aware trafficking which is not provided by the MPLS. So suppose I'm giving you one of the example. Suppose you have three locations and all of a sudden you are seeing that the third locations ERP is very slow, which is main for your business. So you can check your third location's traffic. And you can suppose you have find it out that somebody is using YouTube or somebody is using in some of the OTT they are browsing something on Netflix. So you want to kill all those particular session and you want to prioritize your ERP as in first, right? So from the central locations you can do that. So SD-WAN give you the total flexibility is to do that. So these are the few SD-WAN features. SD-WAN can give you the active-active WAN link. It can provide either both hardware and software CPE, that is the customer premises equipment, in case-to-case basis. SD-WAN can give you dynamic traffic control and each of the policies, which I have already highlighted. SD-WAN give you a hybrid WAN kind of a solution, which is high available in nature. So that means you can have two CPE on a single location. So one CPE, if one CPE goes down, another CPE will comes up and your whole network will be live. And not only that, SD-WAN can give you the minute detail of your browsing history, as well as your traffic and any kind of analytical reporting on your network. So as I am taking these sessions, there might be questions in everybody's mind. Why SD-WAN is better than MPLS? So these are the few network transport medium. These are the few. This is the slides which can give you a little bit about the background. Why SD-WAN? And we are talking about SD-WAN. Everybody is talking about SD-WAN rather than relying on the old MPLS kind of a model. So SD-WAN give you the full flexibility in terms of the transport medium. That is, you can have your own MPLS, which you are already have provisions into your locations, and you can use that. You can use internet. You can use your LTE devices. That is the dongle, all as in transport medium in the SD-WAN. And MPLS, MPLS is work local loop based WAN and wireless kind of situations. It's maybe the RF tower or the local tower. Okay. So SD-WAN, the ease of provisioning, SD-WAN can deploy in 30 minutes, as MPLS deployment may take around one day or more than that. The agility, rapidly scalable. So if that is another site is coming, right? So you are working with another sites. So you are working with right now two sites. Your third location is coming, and you want immediate provisioning of that third locations with a secured network. I am specifically mentioning security, secured network, because security right now is a very key concern. So as much as we are connected, the hacking possibilities or the probabilities is in this day by day, right? So the security is a big concern right now in the whole IT. So within an hour or within 1 or 2 hours, you can provisions the scalable hard kind of locations. You can add that. If what do you need to do? You need to provision one CPE. And you need to add with the central locations, which is based out of Mumbai and Noida. So there will be script which will deploy from the central locations, and it will be in plug and play devices or software devices, software CPE devices, which will basically run on a VM based kind of a model, and it's gone. So integrations with the cloud connector, like any public cloud, so a faster and seamless cloud connector is available with AWS, Netmagic, Google, any kind of one. Applications aware trafficking, so which I have already explained, that Facebook, Twitter, Netflix, any OTT, HoiChoi, that you can kill, or which is very bandwidth heavy kind of an app, and which is not business critical, you can kill all those app and you can prioritize your traffic. So business analytics, in terms of the business analytics, I told you, the reporting is very easy. So for the whole network, you can have the report with a single few click. And as MPLS cost is very high because of the transport medium, SD-WAN is more cost effective in nature. So I just want to highlight. So what are the Netmagic highlight? So our from the network point of view, or from the SD-WAN point of view, we are a total ICT player. So the what that means, not only the data center services, apart from the network services also, we can provide. We can provide the underlay transport medium also, like the ILL or the internet to you, and we can along with your existing MPLS player also to provide you the SD-WAN services. It's a zero touch provisioning, simple and agile zero touch provisioning. Customer portal is available, deployed very rapidly. Security and performance, it's as SD-WAN services has applications aware trafficking in the whole network utilizations can be very optimal if you opted for the SD-WAN kind of a scenario. And secondly, you don't have to rely on kind of an MPLS kind of an situations, right? So suppose you are working on from home, so that also can be as secure as much MPLS if you go to the SD-WAN kind of solutions. And we have seen that around 14% of the savings in terms of the total right now costing which you are bearing on the MPLS if you transport that from the MPLS to SD-WAN. So these are the few things which I want to cover. So if you have any questions in terms of any offerings from us, you can go ahead, or who can. So Shushoban, last but not the least, as yeah. we have discussed, that these. So why these all solutions? So these all services. So I just don't want to highlight on the single services. All these solutions clubbing together, all the services clubbing, stitching together in a solutions. Why all these services are best suited work from home kind of solutions or kind of a pandemic kind of situations, right? So I just want to give you one or two case studies, which I want to highlight, right? So that everybody can have a feel why Netmagic is a suitable partner or choiceable partner for them for their cloud journey and work from home solutions.
Sure.
So as we are going as the industry is moving towards the software defined kind of a model, we are eliminating the hardware dependencies, right? So we are eliminating the hardware dependencies. We are eliminating the physical appearance and all those stuff. So as we all know, cloud is that kind of a solution. So if you want to tell me that why work from home, one of the most key criteria. What is the most key criteria or the main services is required kind of on this kind of on pandemic situations? I will say that it's the cloud, right? So if you don't opt for cloud kind of a scenario, or the you don't host for cloud kind of a scenario, then it will be very difficult for you to work from your work from home kind of solutions, because at the end of the day, if it is a cloud, you can. So Shushoban, are you doing something, or I can continue?
No, continue.
Okay. So
you said you will be sharing some case study. That's why I'm waiting. Because meanwhile.
No. I'm just discussing. I'm not, okay. not sharing any no, presentation. Because, I'm just discussing. No,
because already someone has asked. How easy is to migrate from MPLS to SD-WAN? How fast this can be done? There are some queries.
Okay.
This was one of the queries.
Okay.
So, and decide.
Okay. So
anyone from the audience is having any query, since we have completed the presentation, we are more of a discussion mode. You can raise your hand or you can unmute your microphone and shoot the query as well. Because someone already asking, share some industry vertical case studies.
What industry vertical you want? So Debashish, can you just jot down these all these things?
Mr. Amar, if you can unmute yourself and shoot the queries.
Sure.
Yeah, Debashish, they want some industry vertical case studies. So if you can talk with the marketing team and share.
Mr. Amar, if you are there, if you are unmuted, if you can specify what specific industry vertical you are looking at.
So since I work for a system integration company and we cater to all industry verticals, like I was spread all over the globe. So I would appreciate if you can share some case studies for healthcare, pharma, and retail, manufacturing, utility. Means where you have actual clients who have moved to Netmagic and have found benefits in terms of TCO, ROI. I would appreciate multiple case studies where somebody has migrated from their own data center to Netmagic, somebody who has migrated from public cloud to Netmagic, somebody who is running multi-cloud, where some on Netmagic, some on public cloud, some on their own data center. So mix and match of all these different case studies will really add a lot of value to all the participants here and to myself as well.
Okay, sure. Maybe we cannot show every case study in a webinar now, but we have their mail ID. Yes. Maybe we can discuss and then we can shoot them the case study.
We can share.
Okay, so I just want to give you one industries that is on the sugar industries we have recently given them, this customer is based in East. We have given the total solutions, end-to-end solutions from the network as well as the cloud kind of solutions as they are deployed and they are successfully migrated from their on-prem to our cloud and they are successfully running. They have also migrated their network, the whole network backbone to our SD-WAN services and they are running successfully. Okay. So I will discuss definitely. So to give you the background, initially they were on a remote kind of an UP kind of an UP remote area where there was an RF connections was there and that connections was not that stable. Okay, so I'm giving you that case studies right away. Then in a discussion, this came up that their servers are kind of an edge end of sales and end of sales kind of a model and all are the AIX based platform. Okay, so while discussions we have pitched our cloud as well as we have also pitched our SD-WAN services as to that particular customers. So it was total transformations deal which we had grabbed this year itself, not 2020. 2019 and they are successfully running with us. So they have migrated from on-prem to cloud as well as they have migrated from their MPLS or pure play legacy network system based to pure a software defined and WAN kind of solutions. They have across 12 locations, all across geographical locations across India, and their head office is in Kolkata.
Right. Anyone else having any specific queries?
So Anirban Mukherjee is asking, what are the applications they are using? So they are using the SAP applications, their legacy SAP applications, as well as they have shifted their mailing system to us, and their whole SAP they ECB migrations is done by us. They were in ECC, they have moved to HANA. They were in on-prem, they moved to cloud, as well as they were in legacy network system, they are moved to the SD-WAN kind of a solutions.
What could be the use case for SD-WAN?
So SD-WAN kind of an use case, I just want to highlight if somebody, so use case means you want to understand where you should speak SD-WAN, like for which customer you should speak SD-WAN. Okay. So it's not only the cost reductions, right? So if you really want to discuss only the total, only the TCO, it will not fly. You have to give them the whole ROI kind of thing. So if somebody is asking you just sirf mera cost kam kar do, then wo case banega hi nahi aapke liye. So frankly speaking. So if they want some optimizations on their particular operations, as well as ease of operations, as well as the reductions on the TCO. No, not SD-WAN. It depends case to case. But in my cases, SD-WAN is cheaper, almost 20 to 30% cheaper than MPLS.
Koushik, meanwhile, someone, Somiran from Bangladesh, he has asked if we have any specific use case or maybe you have done any deployment for banking sector with Netmagic or something.
Okay, so banking sector, we have few case studies. I think Axis Bank is running with us. Debashis can give more highlight on particular. And Debashis can give more case studies on the banking sector. Devashis, can you just note that?
Yes.
Sure. What else?
So banking sector, and I just want to highlight you, in banking sector, we are working very closely with some of the banks, and we provide the dedicated SOC services to the bank. Okay. So where our team also sits in the banking premises and provide the whole managed security as a services to that particular bank. Apart from that, we provide, we help them to build their private cloud, which is running from our data centers. Okay. So as banking sector has a stringent kind of an guideline in terms of the data, they have not moved into a pure play kind of an private cloud, public cloud kind of a model, but they are working with us in terms of the security services, as well as the private cloud services, the colo services. These are the services which a lot of banks has opted from Netmagic.
Mr. Amit Khan, I think I have unmuted you. Shoot your queries so that it will be easier to discuss. Mr. Khan, Koushik, he is having some queries, he was asking, so I thought it is to discuss. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, Koushik, so my question is basically that, to my understanding, when we implement the SD-WAN solution, we still need the connectivity as it is, now, either the existing connectivity or maybe we can change the connectivity, but we'll be requiring the connectivity. So SD-WAN is like managing the connectivity better, isn't it?
No, not really that. So definitely the transport layer is definitely required. So without any transport layer, you cannot opted any services. Like, so there definitely be an SD-WAN. You can take an analogy that you have a road, on top of that road you are building a secured secure kind of connections. So that road may be your MPLS, your internet, LTE devices, broadband, anything. But you need that road, right? Without that road, you cannot go from one destination to another destination. To answer your questions, definitely we need some connections, connectivity. Without that, SD-WAN cannot be cannot work. So SD-WAN main pitch is not that that illuminating the road, but it is that how efficiently, how securely you are using that particular road.
Okay, so that means the cost. Yeah, so cost reduction cannot be this the business case. So business case has to be like the better.
No, cost reductions. Cost reductions is also a business case, because if you tally a broadband and vis-a-vis to MPLS, right? So suppose a 2 Mbps broadband, it costs nothing. Right now a 60 Mbps broadband is giving you around $500 per month, right? So local provider. And a 60 Mbps MPLS will cost a huge, right? So cost reductions is definitely kind of a factor. But if you have 100 or 200 kind of locations and you want to switch to SD-WAN, so if some provider is telling you that within a one fine day, you can switch all of your locations from MPLS to SD-WAN, they are just fooling you. It has to be phase by phase manner. It has to be, there has to be a total workshop needs to be done, as well as if they need to understand your whole network infrastructure, whole topology, how efficiently can please be on mute who are not talking.
So
these are the factors, right? So these are the factors. So definitely there is a cost reduction is there, but yeah, you are rightly pointed out, only the cost reductions cannot apply the SD-WAN. SD-WAN give you more agility, yeah, more flexibility.
Yeah, I understand. Thank you.
Anyone else having any queries? If you can still unmute your microphone and shoot the queries as well for direct interaction.
Hi, I'm Dr. Charu Desai. Can I shoot a query?
Sure, please go ahead.
Yeah, just wanted a case study in public sector, let's say in terms of agriculture, supply chain management, or in any utility bill payment services or e-government services.
Okay,
because
so
the expanse is very high in these services. The diversification in terms of location is so high, so I thought it might be a good case study.
Yeah, so right now we are in terms of the PSU, we are working with, in East, we are working with the Bamalari as a client. And their whole data centers, they're almost main ERP has already shifted to our data centers, and phase by phase manner, a lot of other services are coming to Netmagic. So it depends. Means if you really want to, if you really want to, any specific case studies you want, then Devashish, you can jot it down and later he can circulate.
Yeah, please. I look forward to that. Thanks a lot.
Sure. So,
I'm a colon data center. Are you getting me?
Hello.
Are you getting me?
Yeah.
I'm making.
Yeah, yeah. Please tell me.
Actually, I've got one subsidiary that is NCM Singoli. In that subsidiary, we have got network of MPLS, this is WAN. We are having three-layer WAN there, and we want to go for MPLS. So instead of going to MPLS with existing hardware, can we go for SD-WAN?
Sir, I'm not getting you. Can you just repeat once again? Right now, what is the backbone of your?
we are having a radio and fiber connectivity among the different points. Three layer WAN. So we need to go for MPLS. So instead of going for MPLS from this existing WAN, can we go for this SD-WAN based?
No, Koushik, his question is more predominantly for the hardware perspective. Like he wanted to say, he having existing set of routers, switches, and all, with that he can transfer to SD-WAN, or he is having any specific prerequisite for the hardware. That is the question, I guess.
No. Definitely, there is a prerequisite. So they cannot go with the existing hardware with the SD-WAN kind of solutions.
Yeah, you need specific hardware, so that if you have still specific queries, what is the sizing, what are the kind of hardwares, you can shoot us a mail. We can definitely send you some specifications, some other details.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else, anything, any specific queries you want to shoot? Otherwise, we'll be in a concluding note.
Yeah, Amar here. As I saw in the initial slide deck, there was mention of PaaS, platform as a service. So what all applications are you providing as PaaS, and will it be completely managed by Netmagic, where I will not have my admins?
Yeah, so we are providing mailing solutions, we are providing Redis solutions, we are providing we are providing a database as a service. These are the PaaS for us.
Okay, right. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. I think we are in the verge of conclusion, so I don't see any queries.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Koushik. Thank you, Devashish. Thank you, all the attendees. So you will say get all the session recording on YouTube as per our earlier webinars. So look forward getting you tomorrow also. Tomorrow our session will be our endpoint detection and response. That will also be an interesting session. So let us ride the journey together in the new world. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Koushik.